What's up, y'all? What's up, y'all? What's up, y'all? Ah. Okay, I'm not gonna cut up. Who is this? New hair. It's a lot to get used to. If you've been here along this journey, then you know. But for those that don't know, I have been on a fast, a 26-day fast from social media. Because there were just some things that I wanted God to do in my life. There were some things that I was struggling with, going through, battling with. And I just needed God to really do some things. And I felt like social media had become like extremely toxic for me. I was feeling like extremely convicted and I just wasn't feeling good. Everything that I saw on social media, regardless if the person was doing it with ill intent or not, I was just feeling attacked. So I just said that I wanted to make a sacrifice and I wanted to give up something that I had become dependent on. So decided to give up social media. So that was no Facebook, no Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, none of that. Like, what's the other social media? Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, none of that. All of that was gone. In the very beginning, the fast was extremely hard. If you can think back to day two video that I post, I was extremely emotional. I was very vulnerable. I shared a heck of a lot. Some people didn't really appreciate that, but a lot of people was very receptive and I'm extremely grateful and thankful for that. Throughout the fast, some of the things that I was asking God to do in my life, I even mentioned it in that video. I didn't want to share and go into detail into as far as everything that I was asking him for, but some of the things that I didn't mind sharing, I was just saying that I wanted God to give me my peace back, give me my joy, my happiness. I needed him to bring all of that back. And I'm not one to like sugarcoat or like fake the funk, but y'all, honestly, truthfully speaking, I feel so at peace. I am so happy, like joy is in my spirit. It's really amazing. Like it really, really, really is amazing. Like just to see, and I've been able to watch previous and old vlogs just to see where I've come from. And I know it was like only 20 something days ago, but still, if you knew what I was battling internally, and how I'm feeling today, it's been like a complete 360, like for real, for real. One thing that I do want to make note of, and I don't want this to get mistaken, I am not perfect. I mentioned that in the previous vlog. I'm far from that, hence the reason why this whole journey has been about being perfectly imperfect. I still mess up. I still fall short. There's no, like, I'm just not perfect. So even throughout this fast, every day has not been a good day. Every day has not been what I feel today or what I've been feeling for the past couple of days. However, I'm here today. I'm feeling good today. So I'm just going to continue to take each day by day, and just pray and continue to ask God to move in my life, continue to mold and shape and develop me into who he's called me to be. There are some big shoes that I asked him to give me. So I'm really ready for the journey. I truly feel in my spirit that everything about 26 is getting ready to be different. I told someone earlier, I can't remember who it was, but I feel like there's getting ready to be a drastic change in my life, but in a good way. Nothing like, not at least what has been placed in my spirit, I'm feeling like it's getting ready to be some positive, great, good, drastic changes. And usually around this time of year, around my birthday, the spirit of gratitude and humility is really just heavy on my spirit, and that has not changed. I'm extremely humble. I'm extremely grateful to be in the position that I am. And out this fast, I was able to like redecorate the house, color my hair, work on myself, repair some relationships, and I feel good. I feel really good. Anyway, I do want to take the time out to thank everybody who has been praying for me, for everyone that has sent me an encouraging word, an encouraging smile, said something positive to me, or just been in my space and like just kept the energy right. I'm really big on protecting my energy and my peace nowadays, just because like where I'm headed, I just really have to be protective of those things. So all of the people that have been around me have said something encouraging, positive, prayed for me, just been there, been a listening ear. I just want to humbly, graciously thank you right now. Know that I love you and I really do appreciate you. I know that I can be a lot to handle and manage sometimes. So I just really thank you for being in my corner, being supportive. For those that did not know that I was fasting, for those that have continued to like support me and uplift me from afar, I humbly and graciously thank you for you as well. And I pray for y'all just like y'all pray for me. So I really do appreciate y'all. Now to this part. I have to drop the jewels that were given to me to say in this video today. I'm no pastor. I'm no preacher. I ain't none of that. But I do want to leave you all with some things that was really given to me. And I actually wrote it down this time. So. But what God placed on my heart to share with you all lately in my Bible study that I've been having with my cousin, we've been coming from Job. So a lot of this stuff is inspired from Job, and how I just love how God works, and I love how he will align things. So like how, what's the word that I'm looking for? How on time was it for us to read Job during the time that I'm fasting? Not even realizing, like if you don't know the story of Job, please take out the time to read it. When I tell you Job has tore me up, broke me down, built me back up, and continues to get me together. Honey. That Job. Woo! If I could have a heart like Job, my God. But what was placed on my heart was God's strategy for brokenness. Basically, there are some things in life that I don't have all the answers. I don't have all the tools. But what I was given was sometimes in life, we think that we can patch things up, or that we can fix things with the scent, like with the easy... just a quick repair. But sometimes in life, it requires more. Something that I was able to articulate with the help of my cousin was some things that are broken shouldn't be patched. They need to start over. For example, if you have a vase and it's broken, you don't go and patch the vase up. You create a new one. Sometimes in life, you can't fix certain things. It needs to be regrown. It needs to it needs to be reborn. It needs to be made new. And honestly, I feel like that's what God was doing in me. In order for me to like really be able to be used for what he's truly called me to do, I needed to be broken down, but some things had to change. Some things had to be like reborn. Like it's some things that just had to be made new in me. I honestly feel like God had to change the art of my heart. And typically when people think of art, they think of like a picture. And I feel like God needed to repaint my heart, to make it new, to really prepare me for the shoes and the roles that I'm trying to go in and down. There's a lot of things that I feel like are in store for my future. And in order to prepare me for those things, he had to wipe away some things. For the brokenness and the emptiness that I was feeling, he had to like remold and, you know, do some things in my life to truly prepare me for what's to come. And I'm definitely extremely grateful for it. Even during this time of like him molding me and like, you know, repainting my heart, he still continued to use me. It was people that were reaching out to me, asking me to teach them about fasting. There were people reaching out to me, asking me to pray for them. People reaching out to me, asking, you know, just little things. And I'm no expert. I'm still learning. I'm still growing every day. But the fact that, you know, he saw fit to use me during a time where I'm learning and I'm struggling and I'm battling, I'm forever eternally grateful. Like I said, the spirit of humbleness and gratitude is so real. And I'm just like, I just been reflective this whole day. There were some things that I had planned to do, but they didn't really work out as such. But it's okay, because today has just been a day where I was able to be reflective and just think about where I've come from, even before the fast, till today and where I am. Extremely, extremely grateful. I've just grown so much spiritually. I feel like I've grown so much, and I know that I have ways to go, but I feel so good, y'all. Like, I feel so good. And I'm just, my peace, like, I feel so peaceful coming into my house. I'm just like, I love coming home. I love this joy that I feel. I love this happiness that I feel. And I realized, and this is a quick mention, some of the reasons why I was being so hard and so down on myself is because sometimes in life, and even I feel like social media kind of like manipulated me into thinking that there were places I was supposed to be at this time of my life. Like, you know, there were some places that I thought I would be, and I guess because I didn't, and my cousin really made me articulate these things, but because I had not reached these materialistic goals or these places I thought I should be in life, I honestly felt like I was a failure. And a lot of people would be like, Jay, girl, bye. No, y'all. I know that's crazy to be. I'm 20, going on 26, a homeowner, got my own business, in my career, started my master's program. So it's, you know, I've done some things, but to feel internally like you are a failure because you have not met what society has told you you should be in life is really, really hard. Spiritually, I didn't feel like I was where I was supposed to be. Mentally, physically, I feel like, as far as like a family aspect, I thought, you know, I would be married and have a kid by now. I thought, like, in a corporate or business aspect, of course, I thought my business would be thriving by now. I thought that, you know, I would be somewhat closer to administration or, you know, just something along those lines. And because those things had not happened for me, for me internally, I looked at it as, you have not achieved those goals, so you are failing. That doesn't mean that. I mean, what God has taught me, what God is continuing to teach me is like, stop, you know, using what society bases as successful and just allow me to work in your life. And I really had to like channel that in. Like, even on the days that were hard during this fast, like, Stop comparing yourself. Your journey is not like anyone else's. It's just Jade's. And I was like, dear God, okay, get me right together, you know? So I'm really, really grateful that I did take this time away from social media, because I just had time to like be reflective and be like, girl, you lit. I'm lit. I don't need those things. I know that they will come. They are the ultimate desires of my heart. But just because I have not reached those things yet, that doesn't mean that I failed. I'm still doing very well for myself. And I don't give myself that much credit. I definitely think that I'm probably one of my harshest critics. And I had to fall back. I really had to allow the Lord to pour into me and like get me together. And I'm so glad that he did. I'm so grateful that he did. I'm so grateful for this fast. I'm so grateful for the things that I've learned, for the people that are in my life, for those that are no longer, for the good and the bad, not only during this fast, but even beforehand. And I'm just really, really excited about what 26 is getting ready to bring. I just know that it's about to be a lit year. I really want to stay true and committed to this whole YouTube thing, because this has also been very, very therapeutic for me. So I want to, you know, continue to, I know that I'm not going to commit to this everyday thing, but at least commit to every couple of days, or maybe once a week, or twice every 2 weeks. I don't know, something along those lines. But this platform has definitely helped me throughout this journey, and I'm definitely grateful for it. So with that being said, if anybody was wondering where I've been from social media, I had to take a break. I had to step back. I'm praying that, you know, today, well, tomorrow, well, an hour and like 20 something minutes, that I just received the most love that I've ever received before. Like, my love language is words of affirmation. So I'm just praying that people pour loving, wonderfully made words into my spirit, and that this is just the best year of my life thus far. That is truly what I'm hoping and praying for. So, if you made it this far to the video, then you know that I appreciate you, and you know that I think you loyal, and you know that I love you. Thanks for watching, guys. Peace.